Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr., President of the Republic of the Philippines, together with First Lady Luis Araneta Marcos.
Foreign Affairs Secretary Ricky Manalo, our Secretary of National Defense, Secretary Gilbert Teodoro, the Assistant Secretary General and Special Representative of the Secretary General for Disaster Risk Reduction and Head of the UN Office for Disaster Risk Reduction, His Excellency Kamal Kishore. And may I congratulate you. Your message was very well received, and it was you have been able to encapsulate so much of our thinking. And as you say now, is how to bring it down to the local communities and to our people. His Excellency Yuduk Singabu Senior, Palau Vice President and Minister of Justice. I hope I didn't murder your name too much. His Excellency Sanbuyan Amarskaikan, Deputy Minister of Mongolia. His Excellency Datu Seri Dr. Ahmad Zahid Hamidi, the Deputy Prime Minister of Malaysia. Senators Lauren Legarda, Cynthia Villar, and fellow workers in government. Of course, you met earlier the First Lady Lisa Araneta. The ministers and delegates of the Asia-Pacific Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction, the honorable members of the Diplomatic Corps, our key development partners and stakeholders, we have members of the private sector and the civil society, other distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. I would like to extend a warm welcome to all of you as we gather here in Manila for the 2024 Asia-Pacific Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction. It is an honor for the Philippines to host this gathering of experts, scientists, policymakers, practitioners, bound together by a common purpose. For many years, the Philippines has stood on the front line of the climate crisis. Our geographical location exposes us to hazards such as typhoons, earthquakes, tsunamis, and volcanic eruptions. Each of these challenges has tested the resilience of every Filipino and the strength of our spirit as a nation, as of course it has done to your countries as well. Yes, yet it is through these very trials that we have become more resolute and resolved in advancing data-driven and sustainable solutions to protect the well-being of all our people. This conference comes at a time when our work to implement the Sendai Framework for Disaster Risk Reduction is more urgent than ever. Here we can learn from each other, strengthen partnerships, identify innovative ideas, and adopt best practices. Our vision is clear: to reduce disaster risks and losses, and in doing so, protect lives, livelihoods, and the social and economic assets that underpin our societies. At the heart of our efforts, all our efforts, is climate change, an issue that we have integrated in our national and regional policies. From investment strategies to policy implementation, disaster risk reduction and climate change adaptation and mitigation are now central to how we shape our future. I think it would not be an exaggeration to say that amongst the government workers, whenever there is a discussion or a planning session, there is no longer even a single conversation that we have that does not include an aspect of adaptation, mitigation to climate change. That is how primordial it has become in our everyday lives. However, the increasing frequency and severity of national hazards call for deeper innovation, for closer cooperation, and for sustained commitment from all of us. Through this conference, we are presented with the opportunity to explore new avenues of collaboration, especially in leveraging science and technology to alleviate the impact of climate change and ensuring that disaster risk reduction financing is accessible to all. By harmonizing all of our efforts, I trust we can build an Asia-Pacific region that is truly adaptive, inclusive, resilient, and sustainable. To the future that we are shaping through this conference, and I invite you, everyone, to join me for a toast. In pursuit of mitigating disaster risks, where nations rise above the adversity, here is to best practices and the lasting and deeper friendship among our country and our people towards a sustainable future where no one is left behind. Cheers.
Thank you and enjoy the rest of the evening.